Archive 81. I remember watching this trailer when I first saw it pop up on Netflix.
We're looking for an artist. Someone who can restore a recently acquired collection of damaged videotapes.
Well, what kind of damage?
Fire damage. There's just one hitch. Because the materials are so fragile, they can't be moved. So you'd be doing the work at our remote research facility. Creating this archive, putting this puzzle together, well, it would mean the world to everyone who lost someone in that fire.
I'm Melody Pendris. It's March 11th, 1994, 10:32 a.m. This is day one of the oral history project on the Vista apartment building.
Please, please find me.
Stop the trailer. We have to watch this. Oh my goodness. But then the show turned into a disappointment, and I wanted to get into why, and the main reason for me is because it got away from the primary element that made the show good. So those So this show is about a guy who studies films named Dan, and he is hired by a mysterious company to start restoring this old film footage. And then he starts watching it and creepier things start happening both in the footage and to him. He starts to unveil an explanation for a tragedy that happened both in his own life and in New York City at this apartment building where that original footage was filmed. For me, the concept was by far the coolest part of the show. So you're scared for this girl who's in the past and you don't know what's going to happen to her, and yet this guy who thinks he's safe is also vulnerable. I've got to say, there are some amazing moments in this show. There were times when the episodes would end and it was really good. The first negative of the show is that Dan's character seemed underdeveloped to me. He didn't follow much of a character arc. He was just always trying to help the girl in the footage and going crazy, and trying to act like he wasn't going crazy. He didn't have a major shift, and he was also trying to figure out what happened to his own family. But for me, where the show really went wrong was when it started to unveil the mystery of the cult that was in the apartment complex before it got burned down. There had always been use of flashback, but then in the last episode or last two episodes, they went way back. And I thought that it was cool if they just kept it mysterious and showed some of the footage from one of those films in the 20s, but didn't actually show the events of what happened. And maybe that's an issue that some Netflix films have, drawing out the drama instead of leaving you wanting more. Instead of leaving the mystery unexplained, they explained a lot of the past events. And then they go back and try to fix their mistakes by having an ending that largely isn't explained. Maybe I'm desensitized because of movies like Hereditary, but I also didn't find it very scary. Gotta admit, there were some moments in there that were horrifying, but overall it was just disturbing and mysterious and thrilling. Alright guys, so you can go check the show out if you want, but I personally thought that the main character wasn't written well enough, that the concept ended up ending and it made the show not good anymore. That's actually a criticism I have for the show overall. I thought that some of the twists or conclusions and realizations that they would reveal strangely ended up being disappointing. It's almost as if they weren't using the build-up to the full potential. At the end of one of the later episodes, I was left on a total cliffhanger. I was like, whoa, where are they gonna take this? But then in the next episode, they took it nowhere. And I thought they wasted an opportunity with all the suspense built up. And that's actually how pretty much every episode goes in the new Netflix show, All of Us Are Dead. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all next week. New seat for the computer area. That's pretty good.
I've seen all the movie stars in their fancy cars and their limousines. Been high in the Rockies, under the Everglades. I know what I'm needing. Don't wanna waste more time. I'm in a New York state of mind.